radio experience begins in 3, 2, 1.
Now, if you're ready, we will begin.
Welcome to the Marla and Dave Radio Show. This is reality radio with a couple that keeps it real.
Current events,
pop culture,
music,
relationships,
fitness,
the hot topics of the day. Marla and Dave Thomas. This is the Marla and Dave Radio Show.
Real radio.
Welcome to the Marla and Dave Show. And Marla's just over here. Turn up.
Turn up.
Turn up. What's that? What's turn up?
Look, dude, you already know what's about to come down the pike, so I'm working on my ratchet. This is my ratchet practice since next week.
Just working it out. Now, is it turn up or is it we got turnt up?
It's turnt.
Is turnt the past tense?
I don't know. I'll be honest with you. Okay. I'm just making up some stuff because
I'm just trying to get the vernacular down pat.
It's my show.
Get the semantics.
So therefore, I'm Marla, and I want to remind everybody.
Wait. It's not your show.
No,
our show.
I'm talking in the first person. You'll be responsible for your own information.
Okay.
I'm
not saying turn up.
Well, for my information, I'm
turned
up.
You might need to turn this
down.
Turn up.
Anyway, hey.
Hey.
What's happening?
What's happening with you?
Can I just say this before we get into my mood song? I'm genuinely and legitimately excited to have our guest here.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm going to squelch that. I'm going to drink some water. And I'm gonna just hydrate, because as it gets smoky and steamy in here, and we turn this place up into a concert coming up. Before that happens, I want to tell the MaD family who are watching right now that this shirt this week is
She said it was penance.
This is penance.
You're walking in the door.
Last week, my girls were a little bit. They took center stage.
Yeah.
And I told Dave I should have worn a turtleneck just to reverse the effects of last week's cleavage. I'm sorry. That's all I can tell you. I'm sorry.
I said it would have been funny.
Except I would have burned up. It's 100 degrees outside. So therefore, the joke would kill me. And I'm not willing to smolder for the joke, is what I'm really saying.
Yeah, that's true. Well, Marla, tell us what's going on. You got something coming up pretty soon?
Why
are you saying turn up, turned up?
Well, I have to practice my turn up effect because Monday, Love & Hip Hop Hollywood drops, and I am on that cast. So I will be in your living room trying to impart some wisdom to the world of ratchetivity. I'm trying.
The world of ratchetivity.
Yes, I'm connected.
All kind of new words here.
Ratchetivity by association is what I'm claiming. That's what happens. Our daughter Monice is the star of Love & Hip Hop Hollywood, along with our grandson's father, Fizzo. You know, he started Little Fizz. Then I guess he got too big to be Little Fizz. Then he just became Fizz. Now he's Air Fizzo. What, is he flying? I don't get it. Like, what? How do you change these tags?
He's trying to get some Jordans. I'm not mad at him.
Anyway, that's the turn up practice. I got to try to, what's up? I'm turn up. Turnt up. See, it'll never work.
It doesn't sound right coming from
you. It doesn't work.
I'm
so I'm going to be myself. Let me just go back.
You know what? We'll be cool.
What?
Let's get our own thing.
I just did. Ratchetivity.
No, ratchetivity. People say ratchet already. What's our thing?
But ratchetivity
Stay
is so
tuned.
Intelligent.
Next week, we're going to have our own word. Not turnt up, not getting turned up or whatever.
That's a good idea,
Dave. We're going to have our own word.
When we actually get into it with Frank, maybe we can even get a song going.
Hey.
That represents the old. I'm down to be old school. I'm so old school that this is I have to bring this to my mood song. Now, let me just explain something to you. I'm honest. So we were on a cruise, the Capital Jazz Cruise, and David was scrambling to get to one of the performances that happened to be our next guest.
Wow.
And I'm green. If it's not one of the five songs that they play in rotation 22 times on pop music, I generally am unaware. I'll be honest. And I said, Frank McComb, Dave said, you know who that is. He's actually one of your favorite all-time songs, which I burned up. And I said,
Matter of fact, I think we bought the CD about 3 times.
It was ridiculous.
Marla kept warping the CD, leaving it out in the car, whatever.
I'm trying to tell you what's funny about that is that this is real. So if you're an artist, and I don't say this about you, it's because I don't really mean it. But I don't. But this was real. And I'd like to play my mood song, and maybe this will remind all of you why I was so insane over the song. Yeah, Tony. I love it. Can we do the album?
Yeah, add another. It's another show. It's a different kind of show.
Anyway, that was my mood song, and that was written all over your face, and our esteemed Frank McComb.
Well, I'll put it to you like this. We had to actually, Take Six was performing on a show last weekend. Frank was there as well. We had to, after his performance, we had to literally the next day send him a video, put up a video. The dude's not even human. He's sitting right here. I can't even talk to him as a human being.
But you know what's
Frank
funny?
Frank is in the house. He's an alien from outer space sent here with a musical weaponry that he just plays all over the place.
And let me just explain this too.
I'm hands down, man. I don't get it, bro. I really don't get
when
it.
When you hang out,
you are a musicians. Trust me when I say.
When you hang out with musicians and when you hang out with guys like Take Six and people who are like cornerstones of music, who really are true musicians. And this is what I like to do when I go to an event such as the Rhodes Fest, which we talked about briefly last week. I like to hear who the guys are raving about. I left. He called me up. Marla.
Left too soon.
You left too soon. Frank's not real. He's not human.
Premature music appreciator.
Anyway.
Man, I was in the green room, and I'm hearing this, and I said, oh, my God, I cannot appreciate this on a screen. I had to leave, go around
the
back.
Yeah, he did. He was on the
stage.
Came
out to the audience. I was on the stage. I was like, no, I need to see in front of the speaker. Came out to the audience, and I'm like, what is wrong? I almost ran up to the front of the stage, literally from the audience.
What were you going
to
do, Dave? Throw your...
The usher was getting mad at me. He's like, you're making a little bit too much noise. I was like, what? That's what we're doing
but
here.
But my feet are scurrying towards this incredible music.
Anyway, so the other, about two years ago, I'm driving down the street, and I hear this song, and I'm like, what? What is this? Are you kidding me? Donny Hathaway has a new project out?
Oh, that's right.
This is what I was hearing.
That was the other. Yeah.
Tony, hit me.
Take it from me. Someday we'll all be free.
Oh, my God.
That's crazy.
And so I'm listening to this beautiful timbre, and I'm like, man, this got remastered and everything. I don't know. I've never heard this performance before. Lo and behold, right after they say, oh, yeah, that's new from Frank McComb. I was like, oh, my gosh, this cat.
By the way, and can we
this
turn...
This cat just doesn't stop.
We're going to bring him on musically, but right now we're going to turn his mic up. Your mic is live right now. Frank, I want you to know that you're welcome. I've stopped my husband from stalking you. It's not cool to have a man in the bushes at your
little
house.
Little man crush going on. You know, I'm just trying to get some keyboard tips.
You wouldn't have understood.
I'm going to have to get some alien security to stand around the house.
Little green men keeping Dave out.
Yeah, man. I'm going to have to get some prawns. You know that movie? What was that movie with the prawns? What's that movie that they did in South Africa?
District 9.
Yeah, we're going to have to get some of them things to stand around my house.
You're going to need them. Trust me. This cat. See? I told you he can speak it.
Okay. Frank, we're not only about to turn your mic off, we're about to put you out of the studio. That's not.
You're going
to
have some. Man standing outside that door.
That noise was not cool.
Yeah. I told you. Wait till I tell the fellas.
Oh, and I had my ears under my cap. I saw the video.
Oh, wow.
I'll never tell you what a metal egg is. You'll never
the
know
metal what egg. I said, somewhere around his house, I was giving a note to his wife. I said, you know, if you run around in your backyard somewhere, I guarantee you, you're going to find a metal capsule. Looks like an egg.
I actually bought it from Mork, and I flipped it.
Well, look.
I flipped my ride.
Pimp my egg.
I sure did.
Pimp my egg. We've given you guys a little taste. That's pretty much most of our week in review. Hang tough. We'll be right back with more with Frank McComb.
You're listening to the Marla and Dave Radio Show on the Universal Broadcast Network. current events, pop culture, the hot topics of the day. It's time for Mad News on the Marla and Dave Radio Show. Ladies and gentlemen, Marla and Dave.
Before we get to the Mad News, we just want to remind you that we love it when you call into the Madhouse and you join our conversation. So remember, anytime during this show, pick up the phone and give us a call, 323-284-7826. Now, right to the news.
And the first item up in the news is an Are You Kidding Me? And I really feel sorry for this woman because she's actually, I guess she's being charged with
child endangerment,
reckless child endangerment. And quite honestly, we have been there literally.
Well, that's what's interesting.
Not to the extent that she went, but... You know, it happens. I'm not mad at her. There was a woman, the Gilbert mother, who forgot her baby in the shopping cart in front of a grocery store this week, and she's speaking out finally.
Yes, the baby was left for 40 minutes in a shopping cart in Arizona. Yeah. She has four children, and baby Huxton. Anyway, the three-year-old, when they pulled up in the driveway at home, she normally keeps the car seat behind her seat, which, by the way,
she has a bunch of car seats.
But the baby's car seat, the baby was already in its own carrier, so she takes the carrier and clips it back into the seat. Right,
and it was in the grocery cart.
Right, and she had left the baby in the grocery cart, and an undercover police officer found the baby and took the baby to a nearby store, and held on to the baby while they called the alerted authorities or whatever. Here's the thing. My heart goes out to her because...
We did the exact same thing.
We left Lexi, our baby. We drove off.
Were we getting ready for church or something?
Tony's about to cancel our show.
We were getting ready for church.
And here's what happened. I said, Dave, get the baby. He said, Marla, grab the baby, while we were getting all the kids gathered up.
The other two kids in the car.
We had a circle driveway. Well, she'd gone out the side door and was riding her little electric car. And we left, and we were rushing.
I jumped in the car. Marla jumps in the other seat.
I thought he did it.
And I'm thinking she did it.
He thought I'd put her in the car. And we literally got down the street, and he turned around to fuss at the other kids. And he was like, I told
noise.
You guys, wait a minute. And the car seat was empty.
Well, that's my point. You know, the kids are making so much noise in the car. She probably thought, you know, the baby was in the car. We had to drive back, and, you know, we were panicked. We get back, and Lexi's sitting on the porch in her little Barbie car.
In
a church dress.
Why are you guys upset? I
had
my own agenda. Anyway, that's our Are You Kidding Me? Now, let's get to this. The rest of this has to do with the VMAs. I'm just going to come straight out and say it.
Yeah.
The he said, she said. So, what is it? Is this a rapper's package? Is this a character package that comes with rappers? Because Nicki Minaj got mad at Miley Cyrus and called her out for some comments Miley had made in a recent interview regarding the Taylor Swift kerfuffle, and said, back to this B. Back to this B who was making comments behind me. What's good? What's good, Miley? What's good?
She should have said, Miley just says, we're both musicians.
Fate,
we're both artists.
Good.
She didn't say that. She said, we're both artists. We've been here doing this long enough, so things get said and get taken out of context. Yeah.
But it would have been cool, right, if she said, not your plastic.
But here's a little side note. DJ and I were both looking at it again today, and she smiled after she said it. So we were thinking,
maybe
this
it was
some
a
kind
fake
of contrived
beef.
Contrived beef just to, you know.
Well, it doesn't matter because Miley was so naked throughout the entire night that she didn't. That's all that mattered. She was naked. You have to have really small breasts to pull some of that. I have to just give a fashion statement. Ladies, if you're beyond an A, don't wear that stuff. Just don't. Because, you know, it's one thing to get a little fold
of
underboob.
You know, you just have a size A, then suddenly
but to have a cantaloupe fallout,
the little nipple pasties actually don't really cover the whole areola. So that's the uncool look.
Okay.
Anyway, the
final thing. I don't know if Dave will agree to disagree about this, but first of all, I'm gonna just come out right out and say this: if you watch Kanye West's speech, what in the hell happened with that?
Well, he told you he was smoking before he came out.
I know, but like I said, something way stronger than weed.
And at first, I was like, this guy's ridiculous. But then, first of all, you make the comparison between Kanye West and Donald Trump. Well, Donald Trump is, they're both successful.
Let the kids speak, bro. Let the kids speak.
But if
Kanye,
if you say, is it
for president.
Possible, is it crazy for Kanye to run for president? D's nuts. was on the ballot in one of these states.
Okay.
And it was beating some of the other legitimate candidates.
I'm going to just tell you who's nuts. Between Donald Trump's nuts and
so
Kanye's, I'm going
grabs.
With Kanye.
It's
That's
up
what
for
I'm saying.
Grabs. Anyway, that was the MaD news. We're
we'll
going
to
get back
to the show.
This ain't your mama's radio show. Can you handle the truth? Then get ready for a real radio experience.
Real radio experience.
Ladies and gentlemen, Marla and Dave.
As we promised you
yes.
earlier, you heard a little sampling, but there are so many people that you've impacted or that even impact you in the world of music in a major way. So you may not always, people may not always know their names. You don't. I mean, because it happened to me.
You're going to find
out.
But
I can guarantee you that you recognize the music.
Absolutely.
Because it's really legendary. So when you start, like Dave said, even the song you just played, I remember that too. I just, what is wrong with me? Do I have Alzheimer's? Why don't I know anything? I you know what I need? I need for all of your artist friends to send me their own discography so
yeah,
I can read through
them. I bet you would like that.
Yeah, thank you, Frank. I'm going to start with Frank's.
But we buy them.
But anyway,
we want them to buy ours.
We're honored to welcome a renowned musician right here in our madhouse. Mr. Frank McComb is with us.
Absolutely.
Hey there. I'll write that now. I'll write that now. Hey. You know, when you're in a rush to get away from your enemy real quick. Hey, no, right there. Get out of there real quick.
That's church.
That's a seasoned pastor.
That happens every week in church.
Amen.
You see what I'm saying?
You know, again, Marla gave you the number 323-284-7826. That's the number to call in to speak to Frank McComb or Marla and I, and we're going to get right to it. Frank, what's going on, bro?
You, man.
Oh, man.
No, stop it.
And the other five of you, and then your first lady over here, yes.
Oh, man, are you kidding me? The other night, it just it brings up
Where's
so many questions. Yeah, well, you know, it's kind of uncool because I was busted.
Somebody got busted.
I was busted for taking the video. I didn't say that in the other part.
Oh, so you didn't want to tell us.
That's
you went
what
to,
the usher was like.
You went to jail.
He was trying to take my phone. I was like, look, man, no, I'm actually part of the program. He was like, well, you got to get out of here.
Oh, so that's why you came back to the hotel early.
He said you're setting a bad example to the other guests. You know, people in their seats want a video. We've been saying don't video all night. Now you're sitting up here videoing.
Well, I mean, there was a whole video crew there, so I don't see why you couldn't video.
Well, that's the thing. They're trying to sell it.
You know what we should do?
Wish I had known.
Right?
You didn't
business,
tell us that.
Business, baby, business. I'm a business man.
You know?
Business man.
Well, I have a suggestion. You've been stalking Frank for a long time musically. Just show up at Frank's house. I'll put in a good word with his wife. And
okay,
then you just video away. How about that?
Yeah, well, you know.
Don't do it from the bushes, though. That's a little bit weird.
Frank, do you give piano lessons
on
Skype?
You come out, I'll show you the egg. And
that's
it.
What's
that's
up.
Better.
Show me the egg.
I'm going to show you some stuff people don't know.
We take a trip around outer space just a little bit. Come on back.
Yeah, man.
Get some perspective.
We'll do that instead.
No, man, right. But you think I was joking, and I was joking, but, you know, saying the alien reference.
Oh,
but
of course.
The issue is essentially this. The main thing is you're so talented. How do you rein it in? You know, because when you were playing Superstition the other night, and your version was so hardcore, and you were doing 70. I'm surprised I didn't see a shoe fly up and a foot come up and start playing on the keyboard.
Like Bugs Bunny.
Because you were doing everything. It's like you the connection between left and right, they're completely autonomous.
Well,
has it always been that way, or did you have to practice that?
Actually, I just do it, to be honest. I mean, for years, I played just a Fender Rhodes.
Right.
I didn't have a second keyboard on top.
Right.
I just kept it raw. Just a Fender Rhodes. And even in the 80s, when everybody else was saying, no, not the slight Yamaha, I love y'all to death, even though I'm a Korg endorser. But when everybody was playing Yamaha DX7 in the 80s, I was still looking at Rhodes.
Yeah.
I stayed
just
true
the classic
to the
sound.
Yes, sir. And that's all I played. But then here comes Korg 11 years ago, finding out about a record I did called Straight from the Vault, where I actually sequenced everything on a Trinity.
Oh, okay.
A big silver keyboard that they first put out. And Korg, for me, and it's not that I'm trying to push him, but, you know, I love him to death, but I'm just speaking the truth. Their sequences are so easy for me to work. I didn't go to school for none of this, for the music, for the you know, the engineering, none of that.
Mm-hmm.
But their sequences are so easy to work. I was able to link it with another piece of machinery, and I did that whole album straight from the vault by myself. There's nobody else
wow.
on the record.
Wow.
And it's a long story leading up to that. May need a bottle of whiskey.
But
I will break it
you
down.
You know what?
Bourbon, sit it down, get a couple glasses.
You know? And they caught wind of what I was doing, and mm-hmm. they you know, they
been taking care of you ever
yeah,
since.
Yeah, I mean,
nice relationship,
non-exclusive. So that's a wonderful thing.
That's what's
play
up.
Play whatever
man.
I want to play when I feel like it. But you know, even this keyboard here, the SV1, I did a Rhodes piano for it, and they happened to see a DVD I put out called Live in Atlanta.
Right.
And this DVD had my Fender Rhodes with all my pedals on top, and that's how I would play my Rhodes. Well, they built this thing with all the effects built in. So it's like the dashboard of a car. I can just turn knobs and I'm
nice.
Good. You know, it makes life a lot easier for me.
Yeah.
And it's much lighter than the Rhodes.
And I have to interrupt you because we're joined by an audience here. So the chat room wants me to be sure and tell you that they are saying to you, hello.
Hey, y'all.
So just
that's
so you know.
Much appreciated.
You see what I'm saying? The chat room, y'all. These people here, they want to play with you. He said,
whoa.
Wow. You guys, are you dressed?
Look at God.
Are you dressed?
That's
are you
the
guys,
beauty
you have your
about being
on?
In the chat room.
Because
I got a little
you don't have to be dressed.
Don't come up into my chat room inappropriate, okay?
Amen.
My guests are real.
Amen. Amen. Oh,
yeah,
Lord.
I know. I can do that. That was a wardrobe malfunction. I'm sorry. But anyway.
So let's take it all the way back. How did you get into music?
I want to hear this. This is what I'm very excited to hear.
Give us your musical background.
Well, let's see. How much time we got?
Frank's history. Give us the highlights.
I'm going to try to keep it brief. Well, I can't put an age to singing. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, born and raised. I come from a family of singers. My mother, all of my aunts, my grandmother, they all sang. My grandmother had a total of 7. So it was my uncle, he didn't sing. He was the only boy. But five of them sang, and that's including my mother. I knew what I wanted to do from the time I was a child. I never worked a regular job.
Wow.
That's all I know. So
you don't have one of those stories like my first job was McDonald's and
never.
Now, no. So I read in your bio that I found it very interesting. That was it your aunt? You went up to someone after at church.
My aunt Evelina.
And she said, you said you were so blown away. Teach me how to play.
She's writing a blues tune in a holiness church, which I thought was really cool. The church was about the size of this room.
Yeah,
you know, it was a small. Yeah, my grandmother's church. She was the pastor of the church. Excuse me. And that's one of two aunts that play piano. If you look up Liz McComb, that's the real. That's the artist right there.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, look up Liz McComb, gospel singer. She lives over in Paris. But Liz never had time to teach me. So I talked to Evelina, and Evelina was playing. She was writing this blues tune because she loved Nancy Wilson.
Yeah.
And she wrote this tune, and I thought it was the coolest thing to have all this musical freedom. Mm-hmm. You know, she's in church writing a blues tune, and she said, baby, it's all the same. It's all the same. I said, okay, I like this. Okay, cool. So I said I wanted to teach me to play the piano. She said, all right, Red. That's what they called me, Red. My grandmother called me Red Boy, but Red. Okay, Red, I'm going to teach you soon as you get home. So got back to my mama's house, and she comes to the house with this Tinker Toy keyboard. You know, the ones that had the drums in it.
Yeah, you know.
Those old Casio. Exactly. You couldn't tell her nothing, boy.
That's funny.
So she puts it on the dining room table and says, come here, boy. And I was like, not today. I didn't mean to learn today.
Yeah.
She said, no, you don't mess with Auntie Lena about no music. You sit your little narrow stuff down here. You're going to learn. And it was on the table just like this keyboard, on the table. And she taught me my basic major minor chords. She taught me... she made me memorize the keys, you
okay,
know, and told me what the purpose of the sustain pedal was, and that was it. So 1 hour for 3 Sundays, she worked with me, and she had to take on a new job. So
I was gonna say I wanted to know 3 hours, but I wanted to know why she stopped because I didn't.
Just stop for a minute. You're saying you had 3 hours in total of music lessons?
Yeah, with her, that was it.
Wow,
and she had to take on a new job.
She couldn't
teach me.
Right, but that was enough to you were smitten at that point.
Yeah,
it was done.
Actually, my first instrument was drums. I was at the age of 8, but my brother ended up getting a drum kit, and when I started playing it for real, I mean, it was a toy to him, and it was a real kid. But when I started playing, he got jealous and tore it up. Sibling rivalry.
If it's not gonna be me, it's gonna be nobody.
I was trying to play the drums. He was beating the drums. He beat him up.
Yeah.
So to death.
So you know, I'm gonna be the one. I'm the layman. I'm gonna ask all the questions.
It's all good.
You know, what? Tell me what instruments do you play in total? Like everything that Frank can play. What
if
is
you,
it?
If you can give me something with keys, anything with keys but the accordion, because my coordination just out there.
So nothing, you don't do any string instruments?
No, I don't. They say, a lot of people say it's simple, it's similar to the piano. I don't see that. Six strings versus 88 keys, I don't get it. I just don't get it.
Yeah, it's not linear like a keyboard. Yeah.
Things that make you go,
Exactly. So, I mean, I play piano, I play B3 organ. And I was endorsed by Billy Preston himself. Thank God.
Wow.
Wow.
That's,
yeah,
so
that's a ringing endorsement.
Yeah.
I love B3. I came up playing in church. So they said I was too jazzy, though. They put me out of there.
You know, it wasn't until I used to go to church, and you know, sometimes they're playing the interludes while the pastor's talking. Yeah. I'm hearing little Yellow Jackets. I'm like, they don't think we know.
You know what I'm saying?
They're playing anything.
Yeah, they put me out when I was a kid.
Dave came home one day and he said, "You know, Marla, you're talking in tongues is not that hard." I was like, "What are you talking about?" He starts in.
Are you gonna get me busted?
Yeah, I don't care.
He
starts in with somebody stole my Honda. What? Somebody stole your Honda. What are you saying?
Anyway. I hate to say it, but next time you go to church,
just listen.
If you hear somebody spelling Coca-Cola, or somebody stealing a Honda. Trust me.
They filled with some kind of spirit. How about that?
David, yeah, he has his own church index code. I don't know.
Get back to your history, your background. So three hours of music lessons and then any other formal training?
Well, I went to the Cleveland School of the Arts back in, of course, Cleveland, Ohio. And it's funny. I'm just going to put it out there. It's funny because... I really didn't go to learn the music, which is what I was supposed to do.
Yeah.
I ended up taking lessons in the game of politics.
Because
there were guys there that were there longer than me,
mm-hmm.
and playing, you know, they're like this one guy, I won't say his name because it's not to slight him. But he was a great piano player.
Yeah.
And I was a vocal major, but piano was my minor.
Hmm.
So this school actually we were graded on making it 2 performances on our own.
Ah.
You know, the whole nine. I mean, it was a school for the gifted. Yeah, and it was a school for the gifted. You had photographers, you had dancers, mm-hmm. videographers,
everything arts.
Yeah. And everything arts, exactly. And we would get called for corporate gigs. Hmm. You know, so the Cleveland School of the Arts choir would go out, or the ensemble would go out, or whatever it called for, we would do.
Yeah.
And there was always the Cleveland School of the Arts Jazz Trio.
They would send the same, not mine.
I wish it was. They would send the same dude out with the same group of musicians to all the corporate gigs. But one day they got two calls at the same time. And I asked the head of the music. I asked the head of the music department to send me with another set of musicians.
Yeah,
you know he wouldn't do it.
Wow,
wouldn't do it.
They turned down the gig versus sending me. Wow.
So. That was
that was a wake up call. Did that make you mad or determined?
Oh, it pissed me off real good. It made me determined. I figured what you get in the grade for, I'm gonna go out and get paid for. So I started playing clubs.
Ow.
So I started playing clubs at 15.
There's a sound bite.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now was that a trio that you went out with or just you sitting up there on the keyboard?
Actually the same two guys that was being graded for going with the other guy.
Okay, ended up getting paid with you.
Getting paid with me. That's the shrewd businessman in me. I took them with me.
You're getting a grade for, I'm going to get paid for.
Yeah, and that's what I did. I went to the clubs and I got paid to do the same thing in the nightclubs.
Wow.
See, I started out with all the old guys, though. They would embrace me first.
Mm-hmm.
And they had me going out with them and they would teach me the ropes because I kept my mouth shut.
Yeah.
One thing in this business you got to know how to do is keep your mouth shut.
Mm.
I've been independent for. I'm gonna drink this water. And I'm going to this table. Don't you know that's a black woman?
I'm just playing. That's a black woman in good shape. Matter of fact, so I'm so just playing that I'm gonna have to pay for that on the way home.
Ain't eating for the next 2 days.
You know what?
I joke out of love. Trust.
I know. Oh, that's all they do in my house is clown me.
First of all, I'm gonna tell you something, Frank. I'm gonna say this. Tony, do you notice that Dave is trying to build some kind of alliance because he keeps bringing light-skinned guy in after light-skinned guy, and he thinks of some kind of...
Hey, we yellow boys ain't never going nowhere.
There's safety in numbers.
That's how
Is that what
do.
You guys think?
You know, the president of Yellow Boy Club is Boris Kojo.
They try to say, you know, light-skinned was played out. Light-skinned is back, son.
We never left.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. Okay, so now I have to say this. You mentioned Billy Preston.
Yeah.
If I said right now, Frank,
mm-hmm.
name three musical influences that shaped what it is that you became as your own independent artist, who would they be? Even if we could bring them back, three.
Well, I would have to go with what the people say. They say, well, I have to say four.
Okay, give me your four. You could even go five.
Again?
Because you're an alien. I can't stop you.
With the, I'm talking to my people, man. Talking to my people. Well, the people say Stevie Wonder and Donny Hathaway meets Herbie Hancock and Chick Corea circa 1973.
I say that's a pretty accurate.
That's pretty good. Accurate. Yeah.
That's what they say. So I go by what the people say because the people keep me paid. They keep me broke. Either way, if you buy records, then I'm paid.
Right.
The people are the bosses. And now, you guys out there in tweet land and chat land, y'all have all the power. Without y'all, we can't do what we do. Am I right?
Absolutely.
So make the change. That's all I got to say.
Now,
what
some of the things that they're saying in the chat room is that they came in a little late. Tammy just got there.
He just said, you have all the power.
She said, Frank McComb is one of my absolute favorites.
Oh, that's all right. You my favorite, too. Just don't tell nobody else I said that.
Pass it on.
Thank you. What is it?
Tammy.
Thank you, Tammy. I appreciate it very much. I do.
Before I let you go, before we get out of here today, I'm going to get you to tell me the secret of just disconnecting completely. Because is that something that you learn how to do? Because like I said, when you play, it's almost like you sing anything you want and play anything you want. And even then, I saw you, it's that little on top of the keyboard on the side, pedal board that you're talking about. Did you make that yourself? He's reaching all up in the back, pulling out wires and stuff. I'm like, man, this cat.
Now I'm going to have to kill him. The moment I tell him, I got to kill him.
This cat's reaching in the back.
Bye, Felicia.
I kill you.
just raw wires and tubes.
Bye, Dave. Bye now.
Raw wires and tubes and switches.
That's my Herbie box.
Wow,
that's,
man.
That's my Herbie box. You know, there's, I got a couple toys in the box.
I like it.
And I tweak the piano when I play. I can't tell you all the secrets, dude.
Don't tell me all the secrets. No.
I try every day.
I might be willing to go through the rest of my life crippled just to get this information for you guys.
Yeah, I got a couple things in there that I put together.
But do you make them yourself is what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I just get different pedals and put them together. Like a guitar pedal, like a pedal board for guitar. I just keep them all in a box and I just create my own little unique sounds. Make myself a little different. Than everybody
I
else,
like it.
Know.
Well, we're going to ask you to switch seats and put you on the throne.
But
before, while you're headed to the throne, here's a question that we have. We want to come back with this answer from you.
Yeah.
Someone in the chat room, Sandra Hawkins, is asking,
yes. Good
who
question.
Are three musical performers today that you really admire? Don't answer it. Think about it.
I'm going to have to think about that.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
Amen, amen.
We'll be right back.
Years of marriage from two unique perspectives equals 52 years of relationship experience. It's time for Ask Marla and Dave. Answers to your questions about life, love, and relationship based on Marla and Dave's real life experience. It's about to get real. Ask Marla and Dave.
All right, it's time for Ask Marla and Dave, and our motto is, if you don't ask, we can't tell. Someone wrote in with the question and said, hi guys. I guess that includes you too, Marla.
Yeah.
I'm 8 months pregnant with my first baby, a little boy. My husband and I are in a standoff about whether or not to circumcise the baby.
Cut his penis. Cut his penis.
Ow. I think that he should be able to grow up and make that decision for himself. My husband feels it should be done while he's young at birth. What are your thoughts?
Here's what I think.
I don't know anybody who would circumcise themselves.
I know people who got circumcised. I know someone who got circumcised in high school.
Ouch.
Because it was a religious issue, and when they joined the Seventh-day Adventist Church, they weren't religious, and then their mom decided to circumcise them as young men.
Ooh, wait, your mom decides to circumcise you?
I'm going to be real. My dad got circumcised in the marriage with my mother.
That's love. That's some love right there.
We hung my dad's foreskin over the door. No, I'm just kidding.
I had to stop.
Well, told us it was jerky, but we worshiped. We went under. No.
let's answer the question. So right now, my advice would be, you know, you guys really need to come together on this because a young man's manhood, so to speak, is at stake.
I personally feel like that if it's a choice one way or another, you do it when they're babies. You know, you allow that. And I guess the issue used to be about health.
Yeah.
And when there's no health at risk, as a woman, I would prefer that, meaning that, you know, as this young man mm-hmm. grows into his manhood and engages
starts
in
to
sex.
Whip it out.
Yeah. Then, you know, it's a lot of extra baggage to carry. He's got, you know,
I would think that, you know, after gym class, he might be embarrassed if he's the only one, but I guess nowadays that's not necessarily the case.
He could be Snuffleupagus. I mean, that could be his nickname.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Okay. Anyway, it's so much of a personal decision what you do on this issue. I think you might have us stumped for once.
No, I think that it's something you can work through, but I'm saying that err on the side of the circumcision if there's not a medical reason why not. That's what I say.
Or a religious reason why not.
Right.
Anyway, that's Ask Marla and Dave. Again, if you don't ask, we can't tell. You find Ask Marla and Dave right here at www.marlandave.com, our home when we're not here in the studio with you at UBN. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Marla and Dave Radio Show. Marla and Dave want to talk to you. Phone lines are open at 323-284-7826. 323-284-7826.
Okay, so right off the bat, I got to remind everybody, we have Frank McComb in the studio with us. Marla and Dave are always here. Tony's here with us always. Call any one of us at any time. We love to hear from you. We aren't here to actually talk at you, but with you. So give us a call here in the Madhouse and join our conversation, 323-284-7826. But I want to add on to that. Now, Frank.
Yes.
You are on the throne now, the throne of musician alien greatness.
In my house, the throne meant something different.
Well, we're
doing a little something different first thing in the morning.
And I heard he makes it stinky, so it's all good. Here's the point. When I saw you on the cruise, you were in the piano room.
The living room, yeah.
And that was, again, a first for us. One of the few places, Dave didn't even have a voice. We were hosting that year. And Dave was like, I just want to go hang out at the piano bar with Frank. And we were literally in the piano bar till 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning. And this man was at the keyboard, at the piano, playing and singing
just
all kinds of songs. So that's what I want to ask you. Are we open for requests now?
I haven't taken my Ginkgo today. I don't know if I'm gonna remember words.
You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna lie. But it all depends on the song. I ain't scared.
Okay.
It's like being in concert. I mean, no two Frank McComb shows are ever like. I mean, I do living room style concerts, like
where
I invite people to, you know, I give my likeness to the people. They come up and jam with me or whatever.
Right. Yeah,
and if I don't know the words, hell, I just
say
we
this.
Just make it fun. That's part of the show.
Do your thing.
You're also one of the only few people that has ever gotten another artist who's got, maybe Layla Hathaway, maybe one other, who's gotten my husband to just randomly sing off the cuff. You called him up. Normally he's like, no.
Yeah, normally he wouldn't.
But Dave actually jumped in there and did it.
It was cool because we had a lot of people too. Frankie Beverly came through. Fred Hammond came through. Shantae Moore, Patty Austin, Phil Perry. We had a lot of people come through there. Tanya Dawson, Eric Robeson, just a bunch of people. We had a good time up in that.
You haven't been to a Capital Jazz Super Cruise, you don't know what you're missing. I suggest you get to it quick.
Right. And
if I'm on it.
Right.
I manage it. Me
I'm
too.
I'm just saying. You got to get the right mix up in that ship.
Yeah.
Up in that ship.
Oh, they got requests coming in already.
No, they better.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, the phone's ringing?
No,
oh,
Osman Lord. Said, can you just get a little bit of the wine as the question is?
That ain't a Frank McComb song, though.
Gotta
get a Frank McComb song. The wine has got theirs. It's my turn.
I love it.
Okay, tell me what.
They got this.
Now, like sometimes people say, do you have a favorite child? When they ask Marla and I that, do you have a favorite?
I say, of course.
One of your own songs.
actually, well.
One that you like
to
perform.
It's the other way around. I have
songs that you don't like as much.
Yeah, I have an actual album that I'm not that favorite, that I'm really not that partial to.
Why? Tell me what that album
too
is.
Too many issues I went through, and I just too many
it
issues.
It just brings up an emotional.
Yeah, man, it just make me mad when
bad,
I hear some
bitter taste.
I won't even mention the record.
Tammy wore
but it wasn't one that Frank McComb controlled. How about that?
Tammy's asking for some future love.
Looking. In the mirror of my past viewing how things used to be lonely is the word to best describe what I see.
Wow.
Sadness, stress, and salty tears covered every part of my face until our love have fallen into place. It's amazing though that I had to go through things to grow, to become mature enough to know that love didn't love me. Thinking about my future, wondering what it's gonna bring. Will it be happy or sad for me? If I could control what's to come, I would add to my future someone so faithful. Unconditional, she'll be my only love. And finally, happiness will be headed toward me. But presently, I'll deal with my reality. The present is the only thing I know.
You're making it rain.
I'm making it rain.
And to my future love is where I'm trying to go. It's amazing to know that I still gotta go through some things to grow, to go learn to let go.
Just insane, man.
Bless you, sister.
Okay, look, I have to tell you this because I know that when you're actually playing, you go all in. I got your back because Dave was actually trying to steal your stuff.
Yeah,
right.
I should have had my camera.
Looking, I saw
what
him doing
was I
like
thinking?
This.
I should have just been like,
I glanced over.
All the mistakes, you don't take all the mistakes like that.
And I was like, I wanted to say, Frank, stop. Dave's stealing. Dave's stealing. He's doing it right now. He's stealing.
Well, I stole it from somebody. So.
Oh, my goodness.
I stole it from a whole bunch
of
folks.
He was trying to figure that out. I saw you.
Now, before we get back to requests, because we got a request that we have to fulfill coming up for Sandra Hawkins. She's a MaD family.
Fave.
Not just fave. She's an anchor person in our family.
You know why?
MaD
let
house.
Me tell you why she's an anchor, for the record. Dave and I, by the way, and I, you didn't know this, but I actually beat Dave senseless on the tennis court when we were in Oxnard. So Sandra
she
Hawkins.
Did. She did. I give her that.
Sandra Hawkins is our official MaD scorekeeper because we actually have
I'm
a court
get some
at home.
On that note.
And we play.
You sure you don't want a shot of whiskey on that note? You got your W's mixed up.
Thinking ain't
and
in
my
there.
Wife always trying to get me on the tennis court.
Thinking ain't in there.
Can she play?
Trying to get beat down like that. I ain't trying to get beat. I'm not a sports dude. I play piano, not sports, and she tries to kill me. What? Like, woman, I can't run like that. Don't you know I'm old enough to be your baby's daddy's daddy?
Wait, I am.
That's hilarious.
All right, we got a phone call coming in right quick. Go ahead, call. You're on with Marla and Dave and Frank.
Hey.
What it is?
How you doing?
Hey,
good.
Who's
How
this?
Are you? What's your name and where you calling from?
PK.
PK. What's up, PK?
Yes.
Preacher kid.
Well, that's what I'm, was just about to go there.
Preacher kid.
So where are you calling from?
I'm from Atlanta.
Okay.
Atlanta in the house.
Welcome to the Madhouse.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good.
We're good.
So do you have a question, comment, or request for Frank?
I have a comment and a request.
All right. Let's hear them both. How about your comment first?
My comment is, I just wanted to say that not only is Frank a talented musician, but he's also a great and a humble guy with just a great spirit.
Yeah, he is.
Wow, thank you.
That
says a lot.
He really, really is.
How much did they give you to say that? How much did they pay you to say that?
Nothing.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. I appreciate that very much.
We concur, by the way.
Wow, absolutely.
Yes. Wow. Oh, can I be ratchet for 1 second?
Okay. Oh, you're going to be ratchet? We just learned about that today.
Bring your ratchetivity, girl. I got your back.
Okay. Hey, Dave. I love you since Spread Love with Tasty. You was always my favorite.
Thank you.
That's not ratchet.
Yes.
I was about to say, that's not so ratchet.
That's not ratchet.
We appreciate it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
And by the way, TK, times get hard. It's PK, right?
Is it TK?
TK, Tom.
Tom, TK.
Okay, yeah, times get hard. So Dave is for sale from time to time. So just that's right.
Oh,
that's
no.
Right.
Yeah, hit me
go
up.
Go to our website. There's different packages.
Yeah. I don't take checks. I don't take checks, though. I can at least give you a guarantee.
TK, but anyway. I'm sorry. Okay. She put a credit card swiper on my neck.
Hey, man, anyway. It's 2015. Sister got to pay the bills.
Oh, my God. Anyway.
Hit me around tax time.
TK, so do you have a request for Frank?
That is too funny.
Yes, I would like to know, would he do either Soulmate or Love Nest? I mean, whichever one he wants to do.
Let me see. Soulmate. Wow. I always mess the words up to that one. So this is the perfect time to do it.
All right. Well, just give us the chorus. Give us a little hit of the chorus.
So I guess this is the perfect time to try it. And you know what I did wrong? But right but wrong?
Okay.
I recorded the song so low in my range that when I sing it in concert, it just does not come across.
You can't
right.
actually
so
give
it
the energy. Yeah.
No, I can't give it the energy. Oh,
okay.
That's crazy.
Let me see. What are the lyrics? If I mess up the lyrics, it's Dave's fault.
Yeah. And I will take full credit for that. Anyway, TK, thank you. Here comes your song.
I want to try to remember.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Life is so funny. How exactly did we meet? Seems like yesterday. But many moons have come and gone away. And I still say that I'm gonna make you my soulmate. I'm gonna make you mine one day. I'm gonna make you my soulmate. Just you wait. Stop running from me. Cause something in you know I can make you happy. Why do you deny our chemistry? Every time our eyes meet, and I'm still saying, baby, that I'm gonna make you my soulmate. I'm gonna make you mine one day, baby. I'm gonna make you my soulmate. Just you wait. Your body is elegant, and my mentality is arrogant.
reckon. And no, I ain't gonna quit till your heart is in my possession. You think I'm playing, baby? I'm gonna make you my soulmate. I'm gonna make you my bundigging, baby. I'm gonna make you my soulmate, baby. Yes, I'm gonna make you my soulmate, baby. I'm gonna make you my one day, baby. Oh, I'm gonna make you my soulmate. Just you wait.
That's just
ouch.
Something like that.
Is it cool? Is it cool to say that's freaking awesome on my own show? Can I say freaking awesome?
It's your show. You can say what you
want. Next week, y'all have a new word.
How about that? That's true.
By the way, retroactively, don't be surprised if we have enlisted my friend Frank McComb to do the Marla and Dave to do Ratchetivity. We need a new
Ratchetivity theme song.
We need a theme song. We're gonna start our own reality show up in this piece.
So Frank, right quick, when you're writing a song, what element comes first?
That's a good one. Lyrics, or is it
changes? Yeah. Is it the rhythm? What comes first for you?
I don't know. It all depends on either the mood I'm in, what I'm watching on TV, what I've had to drink. What I done been through that day.
All right, so we got just a bottle of whiskey. The Jeffersons just went off. And the kids went back home to grandma and grandpa.
That's a good one. That's a real good one. I have no idea. I mean, sometimes it starts with the music. I could be goofing around with a keyboard patch, you know, or you know, before I know it, I come up with a sound and then there's a whole song around it. I wrote a song called All You Need Is Love from the Love Stories record. It had this like,
yeah.
But if you notice, it's the same changes. I stole my own stuff.
Yeah.
So I can get paid for stealing my own stuff. So check out. They only see your shell. They can never tell how you really feel inside.
Yeah.
I'm gonna make you my soulmate. I can steal my own stuff and get paid for my own stuff.
See?
So that's all right.
So who's cashing the check person. And who's getting paid? Who knows?
Same man.
Well, you know what?
Same man.
That's some good stuff.
When we have requests that are coming in that are not just phone calls, but also someone, when we come back, because we're going to end up having to take another break. Mm-hmm. When we come back from the break, someone is requesting.
Well, we got to get Sandra Hawkins.
Yeah, but we did.
The wedding song. No, we didn't get hers yet.
Someone else is asking for Love Natural.
Oh, yeah. I said so.
And he's not getting out of here before I get just a little more of written all over your face.
Oh, God.
I'll wait.
Well, Sandra Hawkins is celebrating, she and her husband, their 15th wedding anniversary coming up here pretty soon. And she just wants your version of the wedding song.
My version of the wedding song.
Yeah.
It's the only version of the wedding song.
But wait, because I want to, because if we're going to play the whole song, we're going to wait till after the break.
Or we can go to break.
All right, that's a good
idea.
Take it to the bridge, to the break.
Standing eye, heart to heart.
Happy anniversary, Sandra Hawkins.
Making vows to never fall apart. You're in love together. Harmony your hearts will start to sing. Once you finally place your wedding rings, you'll be joined forever. You'll be as one in love. Wishing all the best for you. May dreams you dream, they all come true. And may your lives be filled with happiness. The world is wishing for you all the best, all the best.
And we will be right back. The Marla and Dave Show with Frank McComb.
It's time for the Marla and Dave Doghouse. Marla has something that should put Dave in the doghouse. Dave has something that should put Marla in the doghouse.
You decide who gets a biscuit
and who gets busted and ends up
in the doghouse.
All right, it's time for the doghouse. Now, I don't know who's been winning lately. I got to actually check in with Sandra Hawkins. I think I've been winning lately.
No, don't ask Sandra. Ask even our
Tony.
Other scorekeeper,
That's
Tony
what
Fontana.
I'm saying. Even Tony's been voting for me lately, so I'm pretty sure I'm winning.
You know what's funny? You just have claimed Sandra Hawkins as your go-to girl.
I think last week, and it's also Sandra actually voted for you.
You know why you're going to the doghouse?
I'm mad at that, Sandra.
You're going to the doghouse because I've had legitimate gripes this week. But what you just tried to do right now is hypnotize me. You brought Frank in here, mm-hmm. and you thought you could have him sing the mm-hmm. wedding song or the anniversary song. And I was going to say yes again. I'm not.
I'm going to start singing like Frank.
I'm not doing it, Dave. I won't be lulled. I won't. Dave needs to go in the doghouse because Dave is a very, as we go on, Dave is a very poor listener. And Dave, there's several things that have happened recently, and I'm just going to put it to you this way. I can bring up three instances where I had a specific conversation with Dave that impacted our family, and he just, whether he's in his own zone or whatever, he completely recounted them totally different, and they're very important. They, you know, from directions to money manners, Dave thinks I said one thing, and it was totally something different.
So I will now piggyback on that and say Marla belongs in the doghouse because she thinks her memory is absolutely infallible. So if I remember something one way and she remembers it another way, who's automatically wrong?
Do you know that a uterus is like ginkgo biloba? It actually brings you another kind of power. You don't know anything about that.
I'll have to get me some lately. It's coming up here pretty soon.
You want a uterus?
I'll start collecting. Anyway, so because of that, I'm saying Marla is she's pretty arrogant to think that her memory is the only one that counts. So I say put Marla in the doghouse.
Because I'm right? I don't think so. Roof.
See?
Eat your bones.
See what I mean? The doghouse. We'll be right back.
What's the action? You'll laugh. You'll learn. Uh-huh. You'll learn. Mm-hmm. You'll get mad.
Shut up.
You'll get happy. But you won't be bored. This is the Marla and Dave Radio Show on the Universal Broadcast Network.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm very happy that we can treat the MaD family to this musical experience because it really is. I'm really enjoying every single solitary second, every single solitary song. I'm serious. Even though that was good. I know what you were trying to do. Now when Dave gets out, our anniversary will come up, and he's going to try to, I don't know what he's doing. Anyway, you know, Dave, I have friends, too. I can challenge you in some more sports. I can't, you bring your friends in here, and they're all light-skinned, sing.
You say challenge me to some more sports.
They are.
Now, Marla, are you actually trying to imply that you usually win when
what
we play
I'm saying
tennis?
Is, I'm going to, no, what I'm saying is, we have a pretty consistent battle going. That's not the point. I want to play a game with Frank.
Right,
Frank, before we get to more music, we're going to have fun with you. We're going to do fiction or fact with Frank. Now, I'm going to ask you a question, and you tell me whether it's fact or fiction. Is it fact or fiction that a child born in 2014 cost $245,000 to raise up until the age of 18, not including college expenses? Fact or fiction?
Costs $250,000 to raise a child to 18 years old. Is that a fact or a fiction?
Born when?
2014. Pretty much right now. Someone giving birth today, the estimated amount, fact or fiction, is $250,000.
I say fact.
That's good, Frank.
I say fact. It costs, the cost of living has gone up. My daughter, my firstborn, she was born, 95? My son was 97. Life seemed a little simpler back then. But yeah, I say fact.
Okay.
2014, in this economy,
Yeah, we need Jesus. Does Jesus come on a dollar?
that's the cash I want.
Yeah, we need prayer.
Okay, so do we have a bell? Ding, ding, ding.
I would think.
There we go. I got a bell. He got that one. That's a fact.
All right, here's the next one. Fact or fiction? The average married couple has sex at least 3 times a week.
Fiction.
Yeah, I'm with that.
Depending on how well, it all depends on how long in the marriage they in.
Mm-hmm. Say over 10 years.
Fiction. She ain't man. She rolling over going to sleep.
But can we tell you something? There's value in spooning, people. Spooning has a value. There's
I always say the value of spooning happens when you're butt naked.
Okay, Dave.
And she's backing up into you.
Dave. Dave.
Spooning is great.
Dave.
At that point.
Okay.
Well, I'll be honest.
Be on your best
marriage,
behavior.
Marriage takes work, especially over time, over years, because mm-hmm. you got all these other things that come in the middle of the two of you. You still got to take care of home. You got to take care of kids. Daddy trying to work. Mama trying to keep it all together. Last thing on both of their mind is sex.
Sex. That's true. That's mm-hmm. why you need
after,
a good partner.
After some time, you know, you guess it's a, you got to work at it. Sex, it goes from fun
rabbits.
To a job. From yeah, from it's a habit doing all the time. You know, you're like rabbit habits, yeah. you know?
then, habitual rabbits.
Yeah, but then time goes by, you know, you're getting older, and your kids functional. And everything, you know, and then the job, you're trying to keep it, and it turns into a job.
Yes,
and
work.
You got to work at it, man. Yeah. You got to work at it.
All right, well, we agree with that. Okay, so fact or fiction?
I was
hey, you know, you get one there. You get one there. Yeah, yeah.
I get my bell in. Yeah.
Fact or fiction that Kim Kardashian's ass
picture
broke the
fiction.
Internet.
No, I'm sorry.
Fiction.
Oh, you got to finish the rest of it. Okay. Oh,
he said
sorry about
fiction.
That. finish the question out. All I heard was Kim Kardashian ass fiction.
He said it's fiction.
That's hilarious.
finish it out. Sorry about yeah, that. I thought yeah. you stopped right there.
There's more.
That the picture of her backside broke the internet. Fact or fiction?
That one's kind of hard for me to answer because I'm gonna be honest. That one's kind of hard to answer because I'm Kardashian'd out.
Yeah, see,
I'm not gonna lie. I'm Kardashian. I don't have nothing to lose.
You don't have anything in the.
I ain't got nothing to lose. Well, I'm Kardashian'd out. Right? So
I hear you.
I don't know, but if I had to choose, if like Dave had a gun to my head and said,
just consider that.
Just say, did it break the internet? Is that a fact or is that fiction?
I never got word that it did, but I'll say fact because I don't know everything.
Okay, so
that's the first one you got wrong.
Can you gong yourself?
It did break.
Can you gong yourself?
Hey, like Price is Right.
All right, but it did not break the internet.
It did.
I didn't get word that it did.
It did, but I don't follow everything. It did, however, get record downloads. It was in 2 hours' time that picture had 70,000 retweets.
That's yeah. If y'all want to see a big ass, go to Johannesburg.
They all over the place.
They're everywhere.
You don't even need an internet connection.
Yeah, I don't care what the rest of the body look like.
And they're not even with even with cement and silicone.
It's real. Yeah.
All right. So now let's get back to it. Do we have any other?
I told you there's definitely more requests. But by the way, Tony says that Tony, you're a musical traitor. He said because you brought Frank on the show. You get a pass from being in the doghouse.
He said we both get passes.
But
you get a pass, too.
I like this guy. Hey, Tony, what's up?
You get a pass, too.
Is it a male or female Tony?
It's a male Tony.
Hey, bro, thank you.
All right, so we have another request.
Oh, man, that's too funny.
Which was earlier, someone requested that you sing Love Natural.
Love Natural.
You do pretty good, by the way, for a man who doesn't know any words.
I'll pass that on to Tony.
Yes, it's his fault. It's all his fault.
Dave.
As the fish swim the sea, like the wind blowing, all the words come naturally to me. That describes just how much I do love you, lady. Like them birds in the air, they fly without a care. Yeah, nothing else compares to you, lady. Like a king treats his queen, there's nothing I would not do for you. I'll travel the whole wide world twice. nights and a day. For you, nothing's impossible. Go to let the whole world know our love is purely natural, though, yeah. And our love will last beyond the end of time. To have to grow a love as strong as yours and mine. Love has to start out as friends from ringing it to grow. Ooh, ooh, ooh. And friendship's the main ingredient for love natural. And our love will last beyond the end of time. You have to grow a love strong as yours and mine. Love has to start out as spring is for rain to grow. And friendship's the main ingredient for love natural.
Nice.
Have you noticed
nice.
That I normally joke around and say, you know, like, put me in the group. I'm going to sing. How come nobody writes me a song? Have you noticed that I haven't said that to Frank?
Yeah,
I'm
no,
very
I'm
intimidated
sure.
by that
lost.
Amount of talent in
You'd
one
be lost.
Being. I'm scared.
Most
he kinda
people
scares
would.
Me. He kind of scares me.
Most people would.
That's very
so,
frightening. Funny.
So, Frank, when you're actually playing and singing, what are you thinking about? Are you just flowing with feeling, emotion? Are you considering what's coming next? How are you doing that?
That's God.
I have another.
I mean, really, I don't even think about it. I just allow myself to be free. I'm not afraid to make mistakes.
Hmm.
I did a record called The Living Room, nothing to do with my radio show, but I had a record called The Living Room where it was just me, a trio, and two track recordings.
Hmm.
No separate tracks.
Hmm.
No multi-tracking, just two tracks. And I just spliced, cut, and edited, and just put it all together and made a whole record out of it.
Wow. Hmm.
And I wanted to go back to the days of the way they made records in the 70s where you could hear the edit. Listen to Headhunters.
Mm-hmm.
The Herbie Hancock
yeah, Herbie
record.
Hancock. Headhunters.
Listen to Chameleon. There's a lot of them in there.
Mm-hmm.
When you can hear the tape, you can hear it jump,
mm-hmm.
you know? And I welcomed all the mistakes, the bad notes, the song speeding up, slowing down, the whole nine. Because I just got tired of it sounding so perfect.
Right.
You know, everything sounding perfect out there.
Right.
You know, where's the humanity in music? It's missing.
Wow.
So I allow myself to make the mistakes. So what? I'm human. What you going to do? Shoot me? You're not going to take my money back.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. I like that.
So I'm just a human artist.
But you know what? You're a true creative soul. And one of the things that I've noticed, number one, I'm a lyric driven person, and the depth and the connection and the emotional story that you tell, that's kind of where I'm pretty much intrigued. And so would it be fair to say that are you in love with love, or is love generally the theme and the changes? Because, you know, love can mean many things, and I kind of hear all of that in a lot of the lyrics that you write. Are ballads your favorite? Are you?
I like funky stuff. I like pretty much everything, but to me, I try not to make the songs personal, because if they were personal, I would never have a reason to release them.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay,
I think I won't say that God didn't put me on earth to be a superstar. I think God put me on earth to speak to people through music,
mm-hmm.
and some people are afraid to do that.
Right.
And I'm not afraid to do that. That's what I was put here to do.
Hmm.
So. That's what I do. I make music for the people to use for whatever way they need to use it.
Well, I can tell because it's written all over your face.
And I cannot remember the reason that was more. That was Joe Little out front. I was just like, you know,
you were playing
the
changes.
In the band and just,
Dave. Yeah. I tell you what,
you gonna sing it?
Dave is.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Ha!
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yay!
All right, Marla, you got the duet. You got the alto. Here we go.
It's written all over your face. Who's gonna be Joe LaVert?
You don't have
Tony's gonna be Joe LaVert.
Okay, but you have to do the harmony.
Here we go.
Here we go.
I did harmony. Yeah.
You smile, you smile, you smile, you smile.
Smile for me.
Me.
Smile for me.
Yeah. Never heard. Now, yeah.
I know that part. Yay.
Hey. Yeah, well, that's all I know.
Yeah.
Boom.
I can't even remember.
Yeah, right.
You did it. You just got my, I'm not going to pay for it in the car anymore.
I forgot the lyrics, man.
Yeah,
we
got to
call
Joe Little.
We
got to
call
Joe
Little.
Okay, so let's move on to what you're working on now. Can we get an number one, tell us a little bit about the project that is currently in the works for Frank McComb.
Yeah.
And can we get a little bit of that?
Soulmate, Another Love Story. Actually, there's a 4-song EP that's out right now. It's called Soulmate. It's a song that the lady just requested earlier. And I'll be honest, I put a 4-song EP out because I didn't know what direction I wanted to go in.
Mm-hmm.
And my last 3 albums were live. Live at the Bitter End, remember Donny Hathaway, mm-hmm, live in Johannesburg, and The Living Room. And then before that, I think my last studio CD was The Living Room. No, I'm sorry. See, am I getting cold? I need it. The last studio CD was A New Beginning. In 2010, I'm proud of that record because it's a lot of stuff on the cover. My daughter Mari actually designed that cover.
Everything
on the cover means something, and that was my turning 40 album. You know, you make the mistakes in the 20s and my 30s. I pay for the mistakes in my 40s. I just don't give a damn about much no more. I can only imagine.
Exactly.
But it happened. Whatever.
Become a Frank McComb fan now before he turns 50.
Amen. So, you know, the people have been asking me about a new studio record, and I put 4 songs together and I put them out. You know, the birds were chirping, so I put some worms out there for them really quick. It's the best way I can put it. And it gave me the opportunity to, you know, just buy myself some time to finish it. And it was my wife's idea. She said, Frank, you need to bounce off that Love Stories record because so many people love that record from back in 2000.
Yeah,
it's like 15 years old now. And what I did was I tried to focus on making really good songs and actually, the remake of Superstition.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
That's coming out. I
you
mean,
said
it's
that
like,
the other night.
Is raw, dude. I'm trying to figure out who's going to play. I mean, Stevie's a hard guy to get. He's so hard to get because I wanted him on the record, but I don't really have the time to wait. So I'm trying to find the right person to take that solo that I need. It's a space open on
dude.
This. And I'm trying to figure out who's going to be. I'm going to call
only,
Najee.
Only you can see the space. Only you can see the space.
Yeah,
because matter of fact, as we go to the next break, I want you to play a little bit of your version of Superstition, man. That's
world. I need my band. I don't have that many hands. Because I got the other keyboard. And
okay.
Yeah, he's not so prepped for that. Sorry, Dave.
See what I mean?
Your request can't be met. Denied.
Oh, my goodness. I feel so sorry for you guys because I'm going to have to leak some of that video.
It's all right.
I'm going to have to leak some of that video.
It's all right. It'll be out soon. It'll be out real soon. I'll get it out eventually.
Well,
wait, right quick, where can we find your radio show?
I thought you were about to ask about the records. You can go there, go to iTunes, get all my records. My radio show, you can catch it on legend107radio.com on Mondays, Saturdays, and Fridays. But now we're changing the broadcast as of September 6th. I think it's going to be
Sunday.
The Legend Network. Legend Network, I think, is what it is. So I have to find out exactly.
Well, we will update.
Yeah.
And from here on out, Marla and Dave show will be following Frank forever. And
cool.
So there's always updates with guests that come on, and we will continue to keep you updated on his information, where you can find him, where you can get the album, where we can lock in his family in a room. We don't want him to miss his family, but he has to have a keyboard. So what I'm saying is, yeah, right. So when Dave goes to stalk him, if you want to call me, and you want to get an exclusive VIP stalking package, I might be able to help you guys.
Oh, so now, when is the, right quick before we go, when is the new project coming out?
Oh, my God. I'm the owner of the record company, so I can stall. I'm hoping
hits
by Christmas.
EPK.
Christmas. So I figured I'll put the EP out for, you know, to help me make money off the record while I'm selling the record while I'm making the record.
I hear you.
So I'm a businessman. Businessman.
So y'all indies out there.
Indies out there, you better start thinking and figure out how to take care of yourself with this game, because that's all it is a game. You got to know how to play it well.
We're going
to
be right back with more Frank McComb.
That's right.
It's time to play the Marla and Dave love game. Here are Marla and Dave to explain how it works.
All right. Most of you guys know that
The Mad Love Game is a game that was created by Marla and me. It is comprised of three categories: finance, communication, and sex. The actual categories that we think comprise the issues that go down in most relationships. It's played by rolling a single die, which have the categories on there, their icons, as well as the MAD logo. And if it lands on the MAD logo, it's wild. You can choose whatever you want. Most people usually choose sex. I wonder why.
No, Dave, that's just you.
And is it just me? Or it can land on lose a turn people. And you don't have quite as much fun. Frank, be our guest. Roll the dice today.
Yeah, roll the dice anywhere on the table.
It's not like shooting craps. It's not like shooting craps.
You see, all the light-skinned guys are the same.
Oh, he landed on communication. Oh, wait. No, yeah.
Well, no, wait.
Marla, what is that? I can't see. Oh, he landed on sex. Uh-oh.
Listen.
Yeah, I'm listening.
No, this is a question that will be asked to you.
We're going to go again.
Let's go again. All right. No. This is a funny one.
No,
this is really funny. So all the cards have questions and answers.
By the
answers are by the Pew Research Center.
Before you go there, I want to just say that I met Frank's wife, his lovely wife and daughter are here, and you have permission to play the game.
Yeah, they said you got permission.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay, so.
Uh-oh.
And Lord. The cards also have a further discussion point. So if you're playing with a group of your friends,
makes
you can have
fun.
A lot of fun when you get into these deep, crazy discussions.
After a shot of whiskey.
Marla and Dave style. So
you
Frank,
might need a fifth messing
Frank,
around in
Frank,
here.
Frank, the question is this. What is the size of the smallest penis on record? Not the biggest. This is nothing to brag about. What is the length of the size of the smallest penis on record?
On record, okay.
On record, this is a real thing.
Like Guinness.
Really?
This is probably the one record that you did not want to hold if you're the guy with this record.
Ooh, I feel
you're trying your best.
Usually size, women always say size don't matter. Size,
this would matter.
That's some crap.
This would matter.
All right.
If your penis is your back, then it's a problem.
7 centimeters.
Oh, I like it. He went to centimeters.
That's actually not bad, but not even close. This guy would go to surgery. This guy would go into plastic surgery for an enhancement and pray for 7 centimeters.
Are you telling me that a 7-centimeter penis with this guy, he still needs a magnum?
He would be happy with a 7-centimeter.
Okay, what is
he? He didn't say millimeter. He said centimeter.
I know.
It's 5/8 of 1 inch.
Okay, that's a clitoris.
No,
I have to say it.
That's a curse.
It's basically a half an inch.
That's a vagina.
That's a curse.
It's a vagina.
And in reality, that's a real thing.
What did his parents do for him to have to pay that price?
What?
The genetics couldn't make up their mind.
That's some Beetlejuice for you. Here's the thing.
No, I can understand plastic surgery for that.
You have to get an extension.
You got to get some Dirk Diggler jumping off.
You
got to get some Dirk Diggler. Now you got to get the Dirk Diggler surgery. They need to call it the Dirk Diggler.
You know what?
Surgery.
When your penis is that small and you check the gender box, you have to check other. You cannot say you're a man.
Well, if he don't have a slit to go with,
because
it,
the testosterone, how would you?
I think the testicles actually decide what you actually are.
Okay, this is Basinger talk. It's too much.
So for the further discussion
can you imagine
point
a
on
visual?
This question.
I want to eat dinner tonight. I'm going to throw up.
Here's a further. It's
it
a
like
half
this?
An inch. A half an inch.
Like this.
A half of an inch.
Like my the
your fingernail.
My nail.
Yeah. So here's a further discussion question. What size do you think women prefer? You just said most women say size doesn't matter.
Can I go talk to Nisa right quick?
All right, Marla, what size do you think?
Let me go talk to Nisa right quick. I need to go.
Do women want the big monster?
I would say that most women would probably want a penis that would be 7 inches.
7 inches?
Six inches. Five, six inches.
So are most women happy then?
I mean, it would be average. So whatever is average. 12 inches is ridiculous. Like, that's dumb. That's not comfortable.
But at the same time, if you got that and don't know how to use it, it's still a problem.
Yeah, that's true.
Amen.
That's true. Amen. But, amen.
Right.
All right. Do we have time for one more?
No, what time is it?
We're out of time. Frank, you
got
let off the hook.
You guys are fooling around with the quarter-inch stuff. You guys are doing micro measurements.
Frank, thanks for
y'all
playing
gonna
the
make
Mad
me go
Love
home and write
game.
Some songs, man.
Not about that. I
gotta write a song to help.
Anyway,
that
was the Mad Love Game. You can get your own copy of the Mad Love Game right there at www.marlandave.com in the Mad merch. Back to the show.
Thinking about it first.
Marla is a feeler.
I basically wear my personality on my sleeve.
But when Marla and Dave get together,
it's like a match dancing with a firecracker.
This is the Marla and Dave Radio Show on the Universal Broadcast Network.
All right, yeah, it's crazy up in here. So it's time for this week's poll question. The poll question...
I'm going to find that guy.
Last week was, should Ashley Madison be liable for the fallout from their exposed subscribers? Your options were yes, hashtag you make it, you buy it, or no, hashtag you play, you pay. I guess you understood what that means. Most people did. They voted 80% yes, you make it, you buy it. Ashley Madison has to pay.
Okay, so this week's poll question is follows the infamous rant or speech, whichever you like to call it, from Kanye West. It's Kanye West had another epic speech or rant at this year's VMAs. Are his outbursts strategic or just stupid? So strategic, hashtag brilliant, stupid, hashtag boisterous.
Okay. And you can always, matter of fact, not you can, we need you to vote on all of these polls right there at www.marlandave.com.
Frank, what do you say?
On the homepage.
Boisterous or brilliant? Is he a brilliant mark? People say he's brilliant, that his marketing is brilliant.
Is he strategic or is he stupid?
Well,
I don't want to call him stupid, but
I would have to be honest with you, y'all might think I'm crazy. I didn't understand that brother one time. Mm-hmm. But I think coming from the seats that I've sat in this business, I would have to say that he knows from what I've heard, because I didn't watch it last night. Let me go on record saying I didn't see it.
Okay.
But from what I've heard, so now I feel like the Inquirer magazine. But from what I've heard, the stuff that he said lets me know that he's on point with how the system really is. He has a unique way of coming across with it.
Right. It's not necessarily the most palatable delivery.
Yeah, but he has enough power now where he can be the black Donald Trump, basically.
Right.
You know, he can speak on, I mean, money opens up the door for a lot of things.
Right.
You know, so, I mean, I don't want to say it. I don't really know his financial status. I'm sure he's loaded. But, you know, he can afford now to say whatever he wants and not go broke behind it.
Right.
There you go.
You know, so, you know, money just makes you more what you are.
So
I learned that from Bishop Noel Jones. Money makes you more what you are. And if you're boisterous, then you can afford to be boisterous.
Right. And make sure you log on to www.marlandave.com, vote on the poll. We're going to get back to the show with Frank.
This is modern American dialogue in a mad world from two unique, fresh, transparent perspectives.
This is the Marla and Dave Radio Show.
All right, Frank, another request came through. It's Blue Light Special.
What is that? Song I wrote?
No.
Oh.
No, that's not what it was.
Yeah, it was.
No. I ain't write nothing called Blue Light Special.
Blue Light.
Love.
I can't do that without the band.
You should. Tammy,
that one I can't do without.
He needs a band. Get out of here.
You know what you can do? Go to my Facebook page and watch my trio play it. 27 minutes of straight, raw musicianship.
What?
I was in Bonn, Germany back in, I think, January. And I was sick as a dog. I could barely sing, so I had to rely on my piano skills. And I just put it on my Facebook page. Jazz Rock TV recorded, like, almost the whole show. And I had them, I allowed them to put this 27 minutes on my online. So you can go to YouTube, but go to my Facebook page.
I was going to say, give them where to find you online.
Go to my website, frankmcomb.info, and everything is there. Frank McComb, McComb, like comb your hair, but I ain't got no more of that stuff. Mm-hmm. Frankmcomb.info, and my Facebook, Twitter, everything is there. So follow me. I talk back on Twitter and all of that stuff. But I just put a link on it. It's like 27 minutes. My actual trio, the guys that's playing on the new record.
Wow.
Killing.
No, they were killing.
Yeah, so you should.
Those are some bad cats.
No. You need to check out the guys in Amsterdam. That's my real unit.
Wow.
Those are the guys that's playing on this 27-minute clip. So I advise you, if you want to see Do You Remember Love, go there.
All right, so Tammy, you heard that. You got it right from the man.
Right from
Are
the
you still in the chat room?
Yeah, Tammy's you there. Better... She's making a fool of me. I was like, I never heard a Blue Line special, so she asked for it. No, I'm trying to give it to
you.
Her.
Let me say this.
That's I have to write it now.
You know what? That's how you know that.
That's prophetic.
That happened last week when I happened to be so into this Ashley Madison conversation, and I looked up in the chat room, and I immediately started talking about, oh, I guess he's blinded by... titties or whatever somebody was saying, and David said they're talking about you. And I was like, oh, my bad. You just had one of those moments. It's okay.
I guess
see,
I did.
Happens to the best of us. Well, I want.
Yes, I
we
did.
Can't. We gotta get. We gotta get one more. Some music. One more. One. I want it to be Frank's choice as to what he.
My choice. Frank. My choice.
It's Frank. Your choice. Your favorite.
Oh my God!
What do you feel?
I don't really have a favorite. It's like trying to make me choose my son over my daughter.
What mood comes out right now? Hey, have you ever written any songs for you, like about or for your children?
Actually, no. They just get all the money.
Yes, all my songs I've written.
They take the residuals.
Let me see. But let me think, Anissa. I just wrote Love Natural for her. I don't know what to. Let me see if I can remember this tune. It's off the new CD.
All right, cool.
It's called She Needs True Love Too. It's about a man who's well-to-do who actually comes across a woman who's filthy rich and surrounded by friends and shallow people. But at the end of the day, he's got something far more valuable, something she can't buy. Hmm. And that's a heart, you know, some love. Hmm. So I'm going to try to... Just poke around.
It's my fault.
It's Dave's fault.
It's Dave's fault.
That's what I do at home, so that works.
Dave's fault.
I'm used to it.
Yeah.
See if I can remember it. There are no words to explain how I felt when she walked by me. Eyes met when she continued to pass and go her way. How clearly I remember that day. The brown in her eyes cried, lonely, I'm lonely. Even though she was surrounded by many rich, foolish friends, those so-called friends. And oh, how I long to know her. I wanna hold her, show that I could care less about all the glamour, 'cause none of it matters. I only vest the truth that she needs true love too. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yes.
What's the next line? I can't remember the next line.
Yeah, it's my fault.
Your fault.
I can't even give it to him.
Man, off the chain. So the best way for people to find you when they want to see you live or to be able to access all of your music, which, by the way, it's a lot of incredible music. So don't mess around. Just go to, Frank McComb?
Yeah, you can go to frankmcomb.info. And my social media is there. Everything's there.
Okay, good.
You can go to iTunes, Amazon, and pretty much any place online and find Frank McComb's music. What else?
Gotta
get my Obama speech in.
Dude, get it in. Get it in. You don't even have to be Kanye.
Yeah. And people, please remember, you have all the power. If I'm not in your city, then raise hell at your local venues and tell them to get in touch with me because I book all my own concerts. They could hit me at fmconcerts@gmail.com for shows. Until then, I'm going back to Europe.
Boom. Boom.
I'm going back to Europe.
That's where you're
South playing. Africa and Japan.
Nice. Right.
But
nice.
I want to play home more because I get a lot of people hitting me up asking me to come to their city. But it takes money and it takes a good promoter and somebody to a promoter that really know what they're doing. I'm going to be honest with you. Don't call me if you ain't got your money ready. I'm a businessman.
I hear you.
Yeah, if you don't know how to promote a show,
please don't waste my time. I say it all the time. Money we make over and over again, but time we never get back. Don't waste my time.
I hear you. Can I say this too? For those of you who may be on the fence and you've tuned in, because I know there are going to be people here that are here every week that may not have known of Frank McComb, and now you do. There are those artists, I define artists in categories because of what Dave does, that we normally are comped the ability to see most shows. Mm-hmm. Then there are those artists that you would pay to see. I would give Frank McComb my money.
Come on with
so,
it.
So, not today.
Can you wait till the 15th?
But maybe, because I did get to sing a little bit of Written All Over Your Face. But here's the point. It's worth it. It's worth it. It's worth it. It's worth it. It's an incredible show. He's a phenomenal musician, period. And really, like the caller said earlier, you know, dude, we take our hat off because you are just a humble soul and spirit. Absolutely. And we appreciate you.
Thank you so much. Absolutely. I appreciate y'all out there. I really do. I appreciate you guys, too. Thanks for having me on the show.
So Frank has had us in his living room. Now he's come and joined us in the madhouse. Frank,
I'm coming back
everybody.
If y'all have me back. I'll come back
for sure.
Again,
for
man.
Sure.
A lot of fun.
For sure.
Yeah, I like this. This
and
is fun.
And just remember that things are about to get interesting next week. It's the season premiere of Love & Hip Hop 2. I am on that cast with my daughter. As usual, every week you can expect that there'll be a segment we'll add to the show where I will be briefly
Marla
dealing with the issues.
Deal with her ratchetivity.
Yes,
I'm loving hip hop right here.
Hashtag ratchetivity by association. It's true. So you can always stop by our Facebook, Instagram, Twitter accounts, the MND show. The Marla and Dave Show.
We are navigating the mad world of relationships
from inside of ours.
See you guys next week.